Oh, hey there, Broski. How do I get my chords to sound clear like this, instead of like this? How do I add some rhythm to my guitar playing like this, instead of... Is baby powder really made out of babies? Two out of those three questions will be answered in this video, because the government doesn't want me to answer the last question. How are you doing? Today, I am going to show you how to do the things I just said. I'm going to explain to you how to mute strings when playing a chord to get a better and clear, more clear sound. I'm also going to talk a bit about how you can add rhythm to your guitar by muting chords in between. It's going to be very useful, very interesting, very practical, and I really hope you will enjoy this as much as I do. Don't forget to follow me on Twitch and Instagram. The links are in the description. Both are really cool, my mom says, so keep that in mind. And it's a lot of fun when we go live as well on Twitch, so yeah, check that out. And on Instagram as well. And I want to give a huge thank you to Tyler and Andy for becoming a patron. Thank you so much. And yeah, now we can get into the video. Let's switch views. Yeah. Oh, and also, before we switch views, feel free to suggest a new video or a new song in the comments. I appreciate it. Or you can also sometimes vote on Instagram which song I do next, so then you can also follow me on Instagram for that. Yeah, let's get into it. So first of all, let's talk about muting strings when playing a chord. I will show you how to do this for, you know, a simple open chord and also for more jazzy chords. Because when you're playing a chord, you don't always want all the strings to ring true. For example, when you're playing a D, you want to sound it like this instead of this. Or when you're playing a minor 9 chord, you want to have it sound like this instead of this. You know, you want to mute some of the strings that you're playing with your right hand. And I'm going to give you some techniques, some tips on how to do that. It's a lot more simple than you might guess. So first of all, let's talk about a simple open chord, you know, the D. Very nice chord, you know, simple as that. But you don't want to hear the E and the A string. You can also see that in the chord diagram, the E and the A string, you know, have an X. You don't want them to be played. You can, of course, if you think it sounds good, but a lot of times you don't want to do that. So how do I mute the E and the A string in this case? And in many cases for open chords and a lot of jazzy chords as well. There are a few different ways. One of them is you can really try to focus mostly on playing the four bottom strings, you know, the strings that you want to hear, like this. Which is a good technique as well, you know, something nice that's useful to master. And the next thing that you can do to mute those strings, which is also really useful, and it's even best if you combine these techniques. First of all, playing the strings, only those strings that you want to hear, but also using your thumb to mute the E and the A string, like this. And what I'm doing, basically, my thumb is on the strings, on the E and the A string, but I'm not putting them down. I'm just resting my fingers on them. So I'm resting my thumb on the E and the A string, really just slightly touching. And you can check if it works, because if you then try to play the strings that you're muting, you should be hearing this, you know? Oh, not that, but just a muted sound, like that. And then what you can do, you can still keep on playing these four bottom strings, but you can also play all the strings now, really, like this. It even adds maybe some extra rhythm to it as well, because you have this in there as well. So that's one technique, really, on muting strings. There's another technique as well, because you can't always use your thumb, you know. Even some guitar players also don't even use their thumb, so I have my thumb quite over the neck, but not everyone does that. So the next thing you can do is make use of fingers that are close by the string that you want to mute. That sounds vague, but I will show you what I mean. Let's do one more open chord to make this clear. For example, when you're playing a C, or C major 7, let's do that. Sounds more dreamy. You don't want to play the E note, you don't want to play this note, you don't want to do... You just want to do like that. So what you then can do is you can use your ring finger, which is the finger closest to the string that you want to mute. If you can see, my ring finger is over here, and the string I want to mute is this E string. I can basically just have that slightly touch the E string to have it mute the E string. You see that? So, and that way I'm muting I hope you can see that. It's probably not. Let me focus. You can see that my index finger is on the C note, you know, the third fret of the A string, and I'm muting the E note with the top of my ring finger like this, which gives it this muted sound. And that way you can mute, you know, strings in general. Look at which finger is closest to the string that you want to mute, and then have it slightly touch that string that you want to mute. In this case, that's the E string that we want to mute. And then you can just play, and again you can play all the notes, all the strings, or just the ones that you want to hear. But you can, yeah, play more around with it. You can play a bit more sloppy, so to say. There's more room for mistakes with your right hand. So now, those are some open chords, but of course, a lot of jazzy chords, which you will find in a lot of guitar tutorials I do, are a bit more tricky, where you can have more problems with muting certain strings. So let's talk about that as well. For example, a minor 7 chord like this, an A sharp minor 7. So in this A sharp minor 7 chord, again, we want to mute certain strings, as you can see in the chord diagram as well. We want to mute the A and the E string. Now, how do we do that? That's a good question that I'm going to answer myself. And again, sort of by the same technique, we're not using our temp right now, but we are looking at one of the fingers that's closest to the string that we want to mute. So we want to mute the A string. The finger that's very close is my index finger. Which you can also mute it with your middle finger like this, but the index finger is really easiest. What you again do is basically you're playing this note, the E note, but then you're muting the A string by having your index finger rest on the A string. So not pushing it down, but only slightly touching it. And then you have this muted sound. You hear that? So there's not really a tone in there. And by basically having your finger already here, having your finger on the A sharp string, on the A sharp note, the sixth note of the E string, it's almost really automatically resting on the A string, as you can see. You really don't have to change that much for your finger, it's already probably touching the A string. Now for the bottom E string, we want to mute that one as well. And again, we look at the finger that's closest to the note, and that's in this case, or closest to the string, and that's in this case our pinky. So same thing applies, having your pinky slightly touch the bottom string gives it this muted effect, or really mutes the string, and also gives you less to worry about with your right hand. Now there's another way you can mute the E string, which is a little bit less obvious, but it's still there, and that's with your index finger, and I'm talking about the lowest E string. That sounds weird now, because, yeah, maybe it doesn't, however, my index finger is like this, you know, it's like, that's how I'm placing my index finger on the first fret of the, on the sixth fret of the E string. However, when I'm placing, my index finger is also slightly touching the bottom E string with like the bottom of my index finger, this part. I hope you can see when I'm talking about this part of my hand, this part of my finger is also muting the E string. Like that. So yeah, this index finger that's muting some chords, some notes, is something that you can make use of well. So I'm talking about the bottom of my index finger is muting the chord as well, because, can you see that? It's only slightly touching it, like the bottom of my index finger. Again, a way to mute the E string. So then you're almost muting it in two ways. You're using your pinky to mute it, and also the bottom of your index finger. Now, it's not necessary to do both. If you're only doing the pinky and it sounds good, that's really all that matters. It's all about finding a way that works for you, because there are also, of course, many different ways to doing this. And this also works, for example, very nicely for the minor 9 chords. And again, you really can either use your pinky to mute the bottom string, but also your index finger, the bottom of your index finger. Again, this part of my finger is muting the E string. So yeah, those are two techniques really to use. But yeah, it's nice to play around with this. It's also nice to look at some chords and try to mute some of the strings that you would normally play. For example, with a D major 7, you know, usually a lot of times you will see this bottom note played. But you will also find a lot of times, especially in jazz, that the bottom note isn't played. So then you're only doing... And you really achieve this sound by, instead of placing your finger on the bottom string like this, you're resting it on there. So then... Just like that. So that's how to mute strings. But as I said before, it might also be nice to mute complete chords like this. Now this sounds of course very bland. But when you add it within a, you know, a strumming pattern, a chord progression, it can sound quite rhythmic like this. You know, and that's what we're really looking for. So how do we do that? Again, we're really making use of our left hand and of our right hand. Let's first talk a bit about the left hand. Yeah, because that one's sort of the easiest, I think. And, you know, as well as with before with the strings, you a lot of times you combine these techniques. So when you want to mute a chord, it's quite simple a lot of times. Let's say you're playing an E minor 7. You can just really loosen your fingers and have them only rest on the strings, that you get this sound, you know. I'm really not pressing my fingers down the fret, but I'm only resting them on them like this, and then you get this muted sound. And this especially works well for barre chords, because then you can, a lot of times only you have to rest your fingers and you have the muted sound. Of course for open chords this might be a lot more tricky, because when I rest the fingers and I'm playing from E minor, then not that much changes. So because you have these open chords, but I will also help you with that, of course. But first, let's talk about this. Again, you just loosen your fingers to get this muted sound. So when you want to edit in the chord progression, you could get something like this. So. Just in between strums, you can try these muted hits. Now, a lot of times, only muting the strings with your left hand isn't enough. And really, to be sure that you're muting the strings, there's a second technique that I will show you, which is a technique where you use your palm of your right hand to mute the strings as well. Because, as I said before, for open chords, this technique of only releasing your finger, so to say, doesn't work that well. And also, by the way, when you're playing this E minor 7, for example, I'm muting the E string again with my index finger. You can play that one as well, of course, but when you want to mute the first string, you can again, I'm using the closest finger to the snare, my index finger in this example, to mute the E string. Anyways, as I was going to say, there's also a way to mute strings with your right hand. Now, how to do that? Good question, which I again will answer myself. And that's by doing this trick with your right hand, which is hitting the strings. And at the exact same moment that you hit the strings with your plectrum or your finger, you place your palm on the strings, like this. So even when I'm playing like other open strings, you can still hear this muted effect. And this technique can be quite tricky in the beginning, so don't expect it to be brilliant immediately. You know, these things take time, nothing to worry about if it doesn't sound good immediately. But the thing you're doing is you're again hitting the strings, and at the exact same moment almost, you're placing your palm on them. So you really get this effect. You're placing your palm on them, yeah, not too far to the right you should place your palm, because then you're palm muting, you know, then you get still the sound, but you want them to be really muted like this. You can first just try this without just keeping your palm on the strings and seeing if you can't hear something. Well, you can hear like a muted sound, you hear, so. And then instead of having your palm the whole time on the strings, you can try to, you know, strum and at the same time place them on there like this. And this technique is something that you can integrate into your chord progressions along with muting the strings with your left hand. So let's start off with the C minor 7. Let's try something like this. And try to mute your left hand as well as hitting the strings with your right hand at the same moment you're placing your palm on them. So yeah, and then of course you can build it up. First start, you know, it's more simple like this. As we just tried, and then, you know, once you get further you can try more difficult stuff like. Stuff like that, you know, try to get more fluent in your strumming, in your strums in general, that helps as well. And just starting simple, you know, building it up really helps as well. And also it's nice to sometimes when you're playing a chord, check if you can hear all the notes that you want to hear and if you're muting the notes that you don't want to hear. So for example with the C minor 7 that we're doing, you know, check if you can, you know, if you hear the notes you want to hear and you don't hear the notes that you don't want to hear. So, and there's one last tip I want to give you where you can use these techniques also when playing a solo or creating a riff, and that sounds like this. Stuff like that, you know, where you're basically, you're playing a riff, a melody, but in between, almost constantly you hear this. Again, a sort of way to add some rhythm. You shouldn't always do this for every riff or solo, I think, because it is quite there, you know, it doesn't always sound nice, it really should fit. So for like a funky riff, this would suit quite well, I think. But what you're basically doing is, instead of playing the note separately, the string separately, like this, you are just hitting all the strings. While making sure that you're muting all the strings almost, except for the ones that you want to hear. So again, now we're using our index finger to mute the bundle strings, like that. I want to hear the D, but I don't want to hear the G, the B and the E strings. And I'm muting the bottom notes with my thumb. So then you can do. And then when I'm playing this note, I'm really using my index finger to mute the D string as well. Again, I'm playing on the G string, but I'm only slightly touching the D string to have it muted. And then you can do stuff like that. And then, you know, you can vary a bit when you do mute, hit the strings, and when you don't, so. So now we're also really combining this technique of hitting the strings with your index finger and muting the strings with your left hand, like this. Of course, you can try this out with many different rhythms. It isn't the only rhythm. You can also do something like. So yeah, try to get creative with this. Don't worry if it doesn't work right away, you know, these things take time and at a certain moment things will just happen automatically. In the beginning you just might to be a bit conscious on if you hear the notes you want to play or not. And again, what's most important if you think it sounds good, you know, if you're playing a chord where you hear a note that you shouldn't hear, but you think it sounds nice, then it sounds nice and then it's good, you know. You don't have anything to worry about. So that's how to play the chords and the strums. That's how to mute chords and strings. I really hope everything was clear. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments. Again, if you have any suggestions, leave them as well in the comments or on my Instagram. And yeah, that's it. I really, really hope to see you the next time. Oh, and don't forget to follow me on Twitch as well, because I'm going live quite a lot the last few weeks and it's a lot of fun, so check that out.